I've been called a dummy before, but I don't have one named Buster. Today we are going to bust some long-term winter storage boat myths. Hey, I'm Sean from Lens Cove Lessons in Boating. Unfortunately, our boats are often in storage for a lot longer than they're on the lake, at least here in our northern climate in Ontario. And even further south, we often have our boats out of commission for longer than we have them in the water and being used. So because of that, over the years, I've heard all kinds of winter or long-term storage myths that need to get qualified. Today, we're gonna bust those myths. So in today's video, we're going to cover wrapping up your engine too tightly. Any cover is better than no cover. You need to have your tank completely full of fuel or completely empty. Your batteries absolutely must be removed from the boat for storage. And mothballs or dryer sheets will keep mice away. If you like today's video, make sure you throttle that like button. Subscribe to get on board for more of these type of videos. So you love your boat and you want to protect it. Do you want to protect your engine more than you really should? I've seen a number of times where people have completely encapsulated their lower unit or stern drive engine, maybe with a garbage bag or a tarp or even shrink wrap, and sealed it up completely. And you're doing more harm than good because you're holding moisture that's inevitably in that drive, in the exhaust passages or caught in other components. And then as you get warm and cold days, you get condensation build up inside that cover. And essentially you're creating a factory for corrosion. Also, if you have an outboard engine, what we want to do is make sure that you don't completely wrap it up for the same reasons. If you have no airflow around that engine and you can't get air in underneath the cowling, you're going to cause an environment where there's going to be more corrosion happen on the internal and electronic components than you really want. So what we do is we make sure that it's covered so it doesn't get too much snow damage or sun or rain damage, but we make sure there's tons of airflow movement up in and around the cover so that there's no extra moisture built up. If you can put your boat inside in a garage or in a large building, it's ultimately best not to have any cover on it at all, just the regular tonneau or mooring cover. But a lot of people have to store them outside, either in their yard or at marinas. And a good shrink wrap with tons of ventilation is the way to go because you've got good slope to get rid of any snow or rain load. You've got air flow if you've done it properly and the air can get in around the base. And you usually put in several vent holes to make sure that you've got the ability for the hot air to get out on warmer days. We see lots of time where you go and get the inexpensive Home Depot tarp, which is blue. It looks just like the shrink wrap, but it has a weave in it, so it's not completely waterproof. And the other thing that happens is that weave holds dirt over time. And as the wind moves that cover around, you'll actually get an abrasive happening on your boat and tons of scratches. The other thing that happens is it's not really tight enough, and over time the strings that you use will loosen off. And so snow and ice will build up in the cover and you can get really, really expensive damage to components, particularly things like windshields. And windshields on boats are really hard to replace. Not many people make them. They don't often make them for older boats. So do yourself a favor and make sure the boat is well covered for winter. I would say the jury is out. And 50% of the time, people think your fuel tank should be full. And the other 50% of the time, people think it should be empty. And you can ask marine dealers or long-term boaters, and they will all give you a slightly different answer. There really is no right way to store for fuel. The myth is that it must be completely full or completely empty. And the truth is, it really can be either. You need to make sure it's premium fuel with no ethanol, and you need to make sure that it has a fuel stabilizer in it for the last run of the season, so that fuel gets stabilized in the tank, mixed up, and run through the engine and the fuel injection or carburetor. That should save you a lot of grief in the spring. The myth: you must take your battery out of your boat for winter storage, and you must charge it all winter long, and you must not put it on a concrete floor. That is a truth that won't hurt the battery, but the absolute truth is that cold term storage won't hurt your battery either. Just like in your car, all winter long, every single night when the engine cools down and it gets well below zero or well below freezing, your battery gets to a freezing temperature, and it happens over and over again. The difference in your car is that every time you restart it, it recharges it back up. In your boat, that doesn't happen all winter long. So the key to busting that myth is that you make sure the battery is in good condition, not multiple years old. It's completely charged when it goes away, not half full. And you disconnect the positive leads, so there's no possibility that the battery discharges more over the winter. Do you like the smell of mothballs or dryer sheets? Not really. Do you think mice do? They don't really care. We've tried for years to keep mice out of boats. And the truth is, we've tried mothballs, we've tried dryer sheets, and neither of them really work. The problem is, they may not love that smell, but what they like really more than that is a nice, warm place to sleep for the winter. I found lots of nests where they've actually used those things to make a nice, comfortable bed. The only thing that will keep mice away from your boat in the winter is a pheromone-based repellent that likely has the smell of urine of one of their predators. There are products on the market available, and yet now that smell's in your boat. So save yourself the hassle of all the mothballs and the dryer sheets. It's a myth, it doesn't work. I didn't blow anything up, and that was probably way less entertaining than any Mythbusters episode. However, hopefully these five myths are something now you don't need to worry about for your boat for long-term winterization or storage. Check out this video here for more tips on fuel and why we'd say that you need premium fuel in your boat, or this video here on more tips on battery maintenance. Thanks for joining us on today's Lens Cove Lessons in Boating. Make sure you subscribe to get on board for more of these type of videos. If you like today's video, make sure you throttle that like button, get out on the water, have fun, and stay safe.